How to draw a camera aperture logo in Adobe Illustrator. First, start off with a blank document. Then, select the Line Segment tool from the toolbar on the left. You can hover around and you will see pink markings pop up indicating the center of the artboard. You can snap to these markings. I can just draw a line like this at any angle, but I want to be more precise. Press Ctrl-Z or Command-Z to undo that line segment. This time, I will double-click on the center mark. This will start the line segment at the center, but brings up the Line Segment Tool Options dialog box. Here, I can type in the precise length of 300 points and an angle of 0 degrees. Click OK. Then click on the stroke. Make sure it is black. Make it about 5 points. Make it bigger or smaller based on your preference. This will be the spacing on the Aperture logo. Then, with the line segment selected, go to Effect, Distort and Transform, Transform. In this menu, I want to make sure to click the upper left-hand corner and make 5 copies. Then rotate by 60 degrees. If I pick different locations, it will change the way it copies and rotates. This 9-box icon is picking the origin of the copy and rotation. Then I want to move the transform in the horizontal direction. This makes the aperture larger or smaller. You can even type in a larger number to make a bigger opening for the aperture. While the original line segment is still selected from the top menu, select Object, Expand Appearance. We can use the Align tools to center the shape. Then go to Object, Expand. In the Expand dialog box, make sure to unblock the fill because we only want the stroke, not the fill. Click OK. Now the object is expanded. Next, make sure you select Draw Behind. You may be in the Draw Normal mode. Look down below the color picker in the toolbar. Click and hold on this icon and select Draw Behind. This makes the next objects drawn go behind existing objects on the page. Then, underneath the Line Segment tool, click and hold the Ellipse tool. Once again, we want to find the center and we can use the guides to snap into the intersect location. From the center, make sure to hold the Shift key to draw a perfect circle, and at the same time, hold the Option on a Mac or Alt key on Windows to have the circle draw from the center. If you don't hold Option or Alt, the circle will not be in the right place. Just make sure the circle is smaller than the ends of the line segments. Then press Ctrl-A or Command-A to select everything. You should see the outline of the line segments. In the Properties panel on the right side, use the Pathfinder and select Minus Front. This will subtract the object in front from the object in the back. In this case, it subtracts the lines from the circle. Next, make sure you have the selection tool and click on the object. Then right-click and select Ungroup. Then off-click to deselect everything. Then click the center hexagon and press Delete. Then select everything again and rotate it 270 degrees since apertures are often depicted with the pointy part of the hexagon pointed up. Hold Shift to snap the rotation to 270 degrees. I'm going to shrink the object by selecting the lower right corner, holding Shift to scale uniformly, and then dragging to the desired size. Then, while it is still selected, hold the Alt or Option key and drag out a copy of the logo. Then I can click each of the shapes and give it a different fill color. You can make many different copies of the logo and then try out different color schemes. It is helpful to have many options visible on the page so you can compare and see which one works best. As we select different colors, we can see the logo turn into something a bit more exciting. Once satisfied, then marquee select each of the logos and press Ctrl-G or Command-G to group them. Once grouped, you can use the Align tools to center them on the page for a more pleasing presentation. Hopefully, you can use this Adobe Illustrator tutorial to make a camera aperture logo or another logo of your own design and adapt it for your project.